constantly have dark circles under your eyes, but you can't figure out what's causing it or how to treat it, watch this whole video and I'm gonna go through different causes and how to treat each of them. Hey guys, it's Dr. Mona, and today's video is all about dark circles. I really think this topic deserves a whole video because I swear it's the question I get asked the most. I'm not sure why I haven't done a video on this. I have a PDF on it, but it's a topic that everyone wants to know about and everyone suffers from. And the reason I don't always have a super clear, quick answer to help is because there's different causes and each cause needs to be treated differently. So if there's one thing that's causing your dark circles, but you're treating it with an eye cream that's addressing a totally different cause, then obviously it's not gonna help. I think with anything in skincare, health, wellness, you always have to go to the root cause of the problem instead of just doing like putting a Band-Aid over it, for example. So I'm gonna go through different things and hopefully you can try to listen to these, identify with what you think is causing it for you, and then you can treat it properly. So let's go through one common cause of dark circles. There's, I'd say, four categories that I think are the most common. So one of them could just be discoloration. So hyperpigmentation, discoloration, sun damage, whatever you wanna call it, melasma. I have it, you know, you guys know if you follow my channel, I talk about it all the time. I have two spots right here that are pretty distinct. I've got makeup on right now, so you can't see them as much. But dark circles sometimes can literally just be discoloration on your skin. If it's kind of closer to your eyes, if it's a little bit of pigment. If this is the case, the best thing to do for this is lightening agents. Lightening agents like vitamin C, like ferulic acid, azelaic acid, you could do a hydroquinone cream, sometimes even like a retinol resurfacing cream can kind of help exfoliate the area and lighten the skin. There's a lot of different ones you can try depending on what you and your dermatologist or esthetician think is best. There are lasers and IPLs and peels that you can do, but even if you are gonna go that route with a laser or peel, I really recommend starting with the topical first because number one, it's going to help you get better results. And number two, sometimes you might not need it. So it's always what you should do for, I'd say, anywhere from 3 to 4 weeks first before you go into a more intense treatment. Now, another cause of dark circles could be volume loss. So this is very common as we age, as you lose weight, you know, naturally you're gonna lose some of that plumpness. It's like when you see a baby or like a five-year-old with these like really cute plump cheeks and then maybe take it to the extreme with someone who's in their 80s and they're looking like, you know, a little more gaunt, maybe you lose a little more weight. Whenever I do comparisons or try to teach something, I like going to the absolute extremes because I feel like that really kind of drives the point home. So as you age, you do lose a little bit of volume in your face. If you've lost a drastic amount of weight, this can cause it. There's different things. One really easy way to notice this is if you look down in the mirror and you can see like a little divot right here. So there's a few different things for this. If you are just starting to lose this, maybe sometimes in your mid-20s this can happen, or if you want to prevent it, something like a retinol eye cream or a vitamin C eye cream can help actually boost your own collagen. So collagen, when we lose, it basically loses that plumpness. The more collagen we can help our skin produce, the more plumpness you're going to get. This is gonna help for little things and for prevention. Some examples I have here, this one is just a Biossance like retinol serum, so you could even use this around your face. This is an Obagi like vitamin C eye brightener. By the way, like I mentioned before, vitamin C also helps brighten, so this could actually be used if it's discoloration or if it's volume loss. Now, I want to be really realistic here. If you really have a drastic amount of volume loss, using one of these ingredients is not going to do that much. I think this is great for prevention if you see it happening, but this is where cosmetic fillers will come in. And where you stand morally on this topic, if you don't want to get them, if you do, it's completely up to you. I'm just kind of here to give you the information, but cosmetic fillers like Juvederm, Restylane, there's a couple different brands. A lot of them use hyaluronic acid, which basically just fills the area. Can last anywhere from like a year to 4 years, depending on what product you use, but that's the route you would go for that. And that's obviously a totally personal choice, but for extreme volume loss, that's gonna help the most. Another thing that could cause dark circles is allergies. So if you have bags under your eyes and you feel like you constantly wake up with bags under your eyes, this can actually cast a dark shadow. So even just the puffiness, so a lot of people that will complain of puffy eyes, my mom always complains of puffy eyes. It's like every Christmas, she's like, get me something for puffy eyes. It's like her thing. This can literally cause a little bit of darkness under your eyes. And this can literally be as simple as maybe it's seasonal allergies. Maybe you're not getting enough sleep. Maybe you're eating something that's causing a little bit of swelling, like if there's too much sodium in your diet. So this, you would just really try to treat what's causing it. A lot of times people don't know they have allergies. I actually developed allergies later in life. You can develop them at any point in life. You could go forever not having them. If you feel like your nose is constantly stuffy or like your eyes, or just anything, you can develop it. So I would try to pay attention to those symptoms. One thing you can try doing is even taking like a Benadryl one night or taking a Zantac or something to, you know, an anti-allergy medication and seeing if that helps. And that can help get rid of a little bit of that puffiness, and that will help with the dark circles. One kind of like off-label fun trick that helps is actually hemorrhoid cream, which sounds really weird, but this is a little trick that actually a lot of models and celebrities will use in Hollywood, because hemorrhoids are inflammation. So when you get hemorrhoid cream, it kind of helps the tissue not swell as much. It brings the swelling down. So if you have swelling on your eyes, like eye bags, and you put a little bit of that cream on, it can actually really help. So, you know, check with your doctor first, but that is a little trick of the trade that they do in the industry. So the last thing I want to talk about for the cause of dark circles is diet. So oftentimes if you are deficient in something, it can cause literally a discoloration in your skin. Like if you're not getting enough iron, sometimes it can cause almost like a darkness or like a sallowness. There's different kinds of nutritional deficiencies that can cause this. So that's also something I would look into. If you have dark circles for a few days or a week and it's not consistent, I don't think you need to go get your blood tested and go that extreme. But if this is really something that's every day and you can't figure it out, and maybe you've eliminated all these other things, I would really recommend go getting a full micronutrient panel. This is much better than a blood test, because it's really gonna check what your cells are absorbing. You know, what's floating around in your blood is not as important as what your cells are actually absorbing. I actually think everyone should get this test on anyway to just, you know, have, but that could really help. And then you can see what foods you might need to add into your diet. Some iron rich foods are like dark leafy greens, lentils. These are great. Sometimes you might need a supplement, so you can kind of work that out with your doctor and see what's best for you. But as you can see, these are completely different causes. So if you have a nutritional deficiency and you're applying vitamin C, that's not gonna do anything. You know, it really, really depends on what's going on. Or if you have allergies and then you get cosmetic filler, like that's not gonna help either. That could even make you even more puffy. So really try to figure out what the cause is, go from there, work with your dermatologist or esthetician, and then you can get to the root cause of the problem. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you like it, please give it a share, like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.